Hello friends, welcome to learncsharp.net. Today we are going to start inheritance. It is very interesting topic. In this case we have more than single class. The definition of inheritance is ability to use features of base class to derived class. Base class means what? Old class, and derived class means new class. That is, superclass means old class and subclass means new class. But this class is existing class. From this class, we can easily create a subclass. Okay, all properties and methods of superclass are available under the subclass. Let us see the advantages or features. Project development process become fast because only due to reusability feature. Because existing feature we can directly use under the new class. Therefore, time is saved. All features of base class or old class are available under the derived class. Therefore, no need to create that features again. And base class members are directly available to the derived class members. Members means what? Data and function. As well as by using inheritance, we can also classify the design of class in terms of different level, main level, sub level. Let us take a look at the types of inheritance. The first one is single level inheritance, that is single base class and single derived class. Here is the multi level. In case of multi level, you have compulsory three levels, level 1, level 2 and level 3, and at most you can use number of levels. But in this case, features are available in chain order. That is, level 1 feature available under level 2, level 2 available under level 3. And the next one is hierarchical inheritance. Practically, mostly this feature is useful because whenever we talk about something, any company or any firm, then there is main branch and number of sub branches. Like this, in hierarchical inheritance, we have to create first base, single base class and multiple derived classes. But all class are derived classes. But there is no relation between that classes. That is, hierarchical inheritance classify the design of class in terms of main level and number of sub levels. Let us take a look at the example. Here we have a simple class, class of student, roll number, name, marks of 3 subject, then enter roll number, enter name and enter marks of 3 subject. But this level is known as a base level, or it is called base class or super class. By using this class, we can try to create a new class or derived class. Under derived class, we have feature total and percentage. Here, use a calData function and simply calculate total and percentage. And show data. Display the value of roll number, name, and marks of 3 subjects. As well as, you can also display here total and percentage. But in this case, whenever we define data members of base class, then there is different scope. The scope is protected because protected members are available under the derived class only. If you use here private, then what happen? Private members never access outside the class. Therefore, these members are not available under the derived class. If you use public, then public means what? By default, global. Therefore, that type of scope is also not useful. Therefore, we use protected because protected members are available only under the derived class but not outside the class. Okay, let us print here percentage also. Okay, now these two classes are ready. but whenever we want to access these classes, then you have to create object of derived class. Why? Because object of derived class is responsible to adopt the feature of derived class as well as base class. You can also create object of base class, but that object is only capable to handle the features of base class. Therefore, generally we create the object of derived class. Let us create an object. You can create number of objects. Okay, you can also give here message. And simply call here the function of get data or get student. After that, call the function of cal. And finally, show the result. You can create here number of objects. And don't forget to write console.read key or read. Okay, let us see the preview. Here is the output. First, get data, get student function is called from the base class. Enter roll number, enter name, marks of 3 subject. Here is the result. Okay. As compared to other features, inheritance is a very simple concept. Okay, but let us see some advanced concept in inheritance. In this program, here also we have a single level inheritance. The base class is of rectangle. We have here protected member, integer length and weight, and function is setData. SetData function accepts the two parameters, and these two parameters are using to initialize the members of class. Okay. Now here is the message: base rectangle is ready. After that, we want to show the details. Therefore, here we simply show the length, weight, area, and parameter. Here we also have two functions, area and parameters. Okay. Now, by using rectangle, let us create a second class box. The private member is height. But here, the new concept is function overriding or function overloading under inheritance, also known as function overriding. What is the difference between overloading and overriding? Overloading means function having the same name but different set of or different type of set of argument. But here, function overriding means function having the same name and set type of argument. But whenever you want to function override under the inheritance, then the rule is carry the name of base class function to derived class function. But in this case, your first parameter should be the members of derived class under the inheritance. It is known as overriding. Okay, here is the function is set data. Here also the function is set data, but you have to first pass here the members of base class and then build its own member. Okay, but whenever we call the set data function, then as per the rule, object of derived class get into this function. Now the role of this function is to first initialize the member of base class. For that purpose, we have simply used here base keyword. The role of base keyword is to call the function of base class and here pass these two parameters to base class. After that, box is ready. Like this concept is for show data also. Here show data, we have same name and same set of data. Here also responsibility of derived class function is to first call the function of base class and then display the details of its own class. Now let us create the object. Whenever we create the object, now let us see the how we get work set data function. Here we create a breakpoint, press F11. Okay, carefully look at the screen. Here this set data the object of box class call the function of its own class set data. Here we come under the box class, but the role of this function is first call the details of base class. Therefore first rectangle is ready, after that box is ready. Got it? Like this, this function gets successfully invoked. Now remove the breakpoint and run the program. Okay, first rectangle is ready, after that box is ready, and body details are length, weight, area, perimeter, height, volume, and these are the details of second rectangle, sorry, second box. Okay, it is very important concept, function overrided under inheritance. Now let us see the example of multi-level inheritance. In case of multi-level inheritance, we have to use at least 3 levels, and at most you can use number of layer. Here we have 3 levels: employee, grade, and pay. Okay, now let us see first base class employee. It has protected member employee code, salary, experience, and name. Okay, under get data function, write the mechanism of scan data, enter employee number, name, salary, and experience. Within the show function, we use here string. Okay, because here the return type is string. You can also use such functions whenever you want to create this application as a GUI base. Then this string you can display on the label box or under the text box. You can also convert this function to a GUI based function, but instead of get data, write there set data function and pass all these parameter as an arguments. Okay, now display the employee code, name, salary, and return the string. After that, by using employee class, here the grade class is created. Here also the member of grade class is protected, because these members are again we will use under the next level. Okay, now here the string is grade. Within calgrade, first check the salary which was created under the base class employee. So if the salary is in between 2000 to 4000, then the grade is worker; between 4 to 6 officer, and more than 6 manager, else there is no grade. Here again we call the override the show function. Call first the function from base class. After that, within this show function, we have already called the calgrade function and then display the details. And now get ready to create a next level. Next level is inherited from grade class, and only one attribute here we have. Here don't need to take a protected data. You can take here private data, because it is a final level. Okay, within the gross we have two variables, deduction, and suppose here is a something HRA. If experience is more than in between 2 to 4, then salary is then the deduction is 10%. After that, it is not a deduction, I think it is a daily allowance. More than equal to 4, then 20% is 0, and then add all these details to a salary, then gross salary is created. Okay, here is the deduction. If the gross is in between 5000 to 10000, then income tax in 12 12% on gross salary. If there is more than 10,000, then 15%. Otherwise, it is 10%. Here also, you can return income tax.
Okay.
Now, within the show function again, we use function of base level. But here, the base level of this class is a grade class. Okay. And base level of grade class is a employee class. Now, perform some calculations and display the output. Okay. Now, here the final level is grade. Therefore, final level is pay. Therefore, let us create an object of pay class. Event.getData, first employee details, event.show and write line. Here, a show function return a string, therefore, show that string under S1 and then display the details of S1. You can also create a second employee and close the main by using read functions. Let us see the output. Enter employee number, enter name, enter salary, suppose salary is 6,000, enter experience 5 year. Okay, here is the payslip, employee number, name, salary, grade, manager, gross, deduction and net salary. Okay. Now let us see the example of hierarchical inheritance. In case of hierarchical inheritance, one single sub, a single main level and multiple sub levels. Here the main level is of circle, protective member is radius. Here we use set data function. As I have told you, this concept is so simple. Now the display the radius, call the function of area and circumference, define the function of area and circumference. Now create a circle. From circle class, we have first created the first level cylinder. Within cylinder, let us take a data as a private because cylinder is a final level. Now, first pass the parameter from base class and then build with its own parameter. For cylinder, we require height. Within show data function, again the same concept we have repeated here. Call the function of base class and print the details of height and volume. Now the same level circle. Here we are creating one more class cone. Okay, but there is no relation between the cylinder and cone. These levels are different. But these levels are same because it has a same base level. Here also set data function. First pass the parameter from base level and then its own parameter. Okay. The concept is same again. Now, let us create an object of both classes, circle, cylinder as well as cone, because these levels are different. Okay, cylinder C1, pass the height and pass the radius and height, details of cylinder, after that details of cone. Okay, you can also try this program by using different logic. You can also convert this program to a GUI base. Let us see the output. Here are the details of cone and details of cylinder. In C#.NET, we don't have hybrid or multiple inheritance. Instead of that type of inheritance or that type of inheritance, we can achieve under the by using interface. Then in next lecture, we will see interface. Thank you.